leatherback is a species of many superlatives. It is the largest of the sea turtles. It may indeed be the largest reptile in the world in terms of average adult size. The shell gets up to about 6 feet long. The thing can weigh 1,000 pounds, even 1,300 pounds. And it is a colossal beast. It's one of the few great big animals in this world that you can walk up to and sit beside and enjoy an hour with without being attacked. In keeping with its tremendous size, the leatherback has the widest distribution of any turtle in the world, any reptile in the world, and indeed probably any vertebrate, including man, because it occupies the oceans and we live on the land, which is smaller. The leatherback nests in the tropics around the equatorial belt, but it migrates to distances, a tremendous distance from the equator. It'll go up to Newfoundland, to Siberia, it'll go down to Tasmania, the southern end of New Zealand. It is a creature of extraordinary distribution, and the individuals are not pinned down to limited areas.
We started the volunteers work in Playa Grande with the Scouts Association of Costa Rica. And we did this in desperation because there was no other way, no other volunteers who were as organized and well-behaved as the Scouts to do the beach patrols. And Mario Bosa, who is Vice Minister of Natural Resources, Energy and Mines, and myself, we thought that it would be a good idea to get other scouts in other parts of the world participating with us in the rescue of the nesting beaches for the sea turtles. So with the assistance of the Nature Conservancy, Mario Bosa contacted personally the Boy Scouts of Minnesota, and they came to visit for the first time in December 1989. And we were really very satisfied with their visit and very grateful for their participation.
This has been a very important nesting ground for marine turtles for a long time. And for that reason, this place was created as a wildlife refuge some time ago. But we have realized that a refuge is not enough to really protect and to enforce the law in order to protect the colony of marine turtles. So at this time, we want to create a national park in this place to cover not only the marine portion that is at present protected by the refuge, but also to include the land portion that is of extreme importance for the protection of the nesting turtles. We know, according to the research that Dr. Peter Pritchard has been doing in this area, that this is one of the most important nesting grounds for leatherback turtles. So we consider that it is an international resource, and that we are in a good position to ask international support for the land acquisition and for the protection of the park. Thank you.
This peninsula that I'm sitting on at the moment extends several miles south from the north end of the beach, surrounded by water, and it is a sort of a protected edge with a hollow interior. If you can imagine a fine piece of wood in an old house that retains its shape, its external is exactly as you would wish it, but you give it a kick and you then realize that it breaks into a pile of dust. It's eaten out by termites. This peninsula similarly could have a dead interior eaten out by development with just a little fringe upon the edge to convince you that there was no damage, but it would be an illusion. The national park need not, though, exclude those people who wanted to come here to enjoy Playa Grande. In fact, the scenario we envisage is one where human use would be enhanced rather than curtailed. People could come here, they could pay a small fee to have a licensed guide take them out on the beach at night, who will tell them about turtles. They would regulate turtle watching, but more than that, they would guide it. So the experience of being here to see these enormous creatures at night would be enhanced rather than destroyed by people who simply didn't know the rules and the protocols. The ecotourism, the turtle walks, the turtle tours, are not going to pay for the acquisition, but they are going to pay for the management and the running of the place in a way that is an opportunity present in very few other national parks in the country or elsewhere, because the tourists already come. And 90 or 95% of the tourists coming here come here to watch the sea turtles. Development pressure is on. People have bought this land. They have in their minds and on paper subdivided it into tiny lots. They are selling these lots. They are starting to build on them. And some of the plans that have been drawn up are, to those who love wild places, truly frightening. So development is the key reason that something drastic needs to be done to keep Playa Grande and its environments, Morro Hermoso, Playa Langosta, in a natural and attractive condition where the turtles will continue to come. Ten or 20 years ago would have been the ideal time to get working on this park, but only a few of us were worried. And it's taken time for the world to get really conscious of Las Baulas de Guanacaste and what it can be. But now we have the support of the locals, we have the support of the international community, we have the people in power in the Costa Rican government right now, and it doesn't happen without that tremendous interlocking of all these energies. We have an incredible variety of ecosystems here. We have dry forest, we have hills, we have spectacular surf-beaten rocks and cliffs on the north side of Morro Hermoso. We've got beautiful and we've got these wonderful beaches with these tremendous leatherback turtles. This park will only happen if we can raise a substantial amount of money. It's going to cost millions of dollars to make it real. These millions of dollars will need to come from you. They can't come from Costa Rica. There is no magic source. It will take a lot of people to say, I believe in Las Baulas de Guanacaste. I wish to contribute to the acquisition of these lands. A national park should be forever. It should be for 100, 1,000, who knows, 10,000 years. So it's a great push to do it now, to get it in place, to consolidate it. It'll take a few years, and then you've got it for all time.